So, Elizabeth, why is this research potentially so significant?
You know, because Wolf, it seems to be a proof of principle. Let me tell you what these researchers at Columbia in New York City did. What they did is they took cells from hair follicles, from human hair follicles, and they put these follicles onto skin that doesn't bear hair, where hair would never grow. So they put these follicles on that skin, and then they put that piece of skin on the back of a mouse. And they waited some time, and what they found was that hair grew. So you wouldn't expect it to grow, but it actually did grow. And so it's, you know, there's obviously a lot more work to be done, but as I said, this is a proof of principle that this kind of thing could possibly work.
But they're saying it's promising, right? As you say, there's a lot more work that needs to be done.
Right, there certainly is. So, for example, you know, hair falls out. So will it grow back in when it falls out under these circumstances? Will it grow back in over a period of years? I mean, there's lots of things that they need to figure out first.
If it does work, any idea when it might really be usable for humans?
You know, it would be many, many years. So they need another 3 to 5 years to keep doing this work until they try it in human beings. Then they have to do those trials, which take years. And then they have to apply to the FDA. It's going to be a long time. And I always like to say with stories like this, this may never come to fruition. This may be the last that we hear of it. But even if it does work, it will take years until someone can actually buy it.